My name's Joyce Stewart. I'm the Director of Public Affairs for the Baltimore County Police Department. Colonel Chris Kelly is to my right. He's the Chief of Operations Bureau. Before we get started, I do want to remind everyone that the Independent Investigations Division with the Attorney General's Office is conducting an investigation into this officer-involved shooting, so I may be limited in some of the information that I can share at this point. But what I can tell you is around 11:30 today, our officers responded to a 911 call in the 400 block of Reisterstown Road. This was for a domestic disturbance involving a male with a gun. When our officers arrived at that location, they were informed that the suspect had left on foot, and our officers began to canvass the area at that point. A short time later, they located the suspect at a nearby gas station. When they approached the suspect inside that location, he pointed a weapon at our officers, who then retreated and declared a barricade. A short time later, the suspect exited the gas station and engaged our officers, and it was during that time frame that the suspect sustained life-threatening injuries. Our officers rendered aid during that time. They did locate a weapon next to the suspect, who was transported to a local hospital where he was later pronounced deceased. Three officers discharged their firearms during this incident. All three were wearing body-worn cameras that were rolling at the time. As I mentioned earlier, the Independent Investigations Division with the Attorney General's Office is conducting an investigation into this officer-involved shooting. Do you have any questions at this point?
Do you have age, race, or gender for the person?
Typically, with this type of investigation, the identity of the suspect, as well as the officers and the body-worn camera footage, that is all information that is released by the Attorney General's Office.
Okay. And what was the initial address for the call, the 911 call?
In the 400 block of Reisterstown Road. It was a local hotel.
What was the initial call for?
Domestic disturbance involving a male with an armed with a weapon.
Was it a gun? Was it the store of that call? Was it a regular person who called 911?
That'll be part of this investigation. Thank you.